Would you like to protect your QuickBooks Online records so that nobody can change past transactions that are already proven correct? Well, then you need to know how to set a closing date in your QuickBooks Online account. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. The closing date is a date that QuickBooks Online will use to make a distinction between transactions both before and after that date. You can tell QuickBooks Online to warn you if you are changing a transaction that was recorded before that very important date. You can even tell QuickBooks Online to require that you input a password before being allowed to change or delete a transaction that was recorded before the closing date. And you can use the account settings window, or let's say company settings window, to set and create the closing date. For example, let's set the closing date for February 28th, 2021. And this time, let's put a warning, no password. So how do you set the closing date? Well, you click the cog wheel and you go over to the Your Company column, and it will either say Account and Settings or Company Settings and open the Settings window. Now the closing date is in the Advanced section of the Settings window. So you click the Advanced category and you can see in the section of Accounting on top, one of the choices is Close the Books and it's off. Click the Pencil tool. Now at the moment that you click it to activate, it's going to ask you what the closing date is. And here are your choices. Allow changes after viewing the warning or allow changes after entering a password. We'll just require a warning and we'll make the closing date February 28th of 2021, just like it is here, and we'll click Save. Now you can see there's a closing date that's set and we click Done in the Account Settings window. Now let's change the February 6th deposit to $250, and as you can see the February 6th is before the February 28th closing date. Let's see what happens when we try to change something. I'm going to click Reports, Trial Balance, and I'm going to double-click the Chase Bank account to get the list of transactions that were recorded into Chase Bank. Here's the February 6th deposit. And if we scroll over, you can see the rest of it. It was $150. February 6th deposit. Double-click. Now, I'm going to change this to, from $150, let's change the amount as per our instructions. Let's change it to $250. Just like changing any other transaction, we click Save and Close. Aha! Look at this message. This transaction was on or before your company's closing date. Editing the transaction will affect your books. Are you sure you want to save it? Yes. And now that we've changed something, let's look at the results of that change in the Exceptions to Closing Date report. That's a report that will appear once you set a closing date. So you click Reports. Now we have to go to Standard because we have not yet customized that report. Scroll all the way down to the section of Accountant Reports. For my accountant, and if you go slowly, you will see that you now have a Exception to Closing Date Report. Here it is. Now, when you double click, look at that. It lists every change to anything that was changed before the closing date, and it lists it in the same way that the audit trail does. So back on December 16th, this transaction was added. Close it out. But you see that this very same transaction was changed on December 27 at 10:48 a.m. And if we open it up, you can see exactly what was changed on December 27th. So that was the only change that we have before for any transaction that was dated before the designated closing date. Let's change things around a little and see what happens. Let's change the closing date to March 15th of 2021. And this time we will require that the person changing the transaction put a password. And the password will be $500. And that's because your accountant is going to charge you $500 to fix anything you screw up by changing a transaction that was before the closing date. So let's first change the closing date and the password. We go back to the cog wheel and we go over to accountant and settings. Then we go to the bottom left and click advanced. And now in the area of accounting, we click the pencil tool and we're going to change the closing date to March 15th. And instead of allowing changes after viewing a warning, allow changes after viewing the warning and entering a password. And the password is, okay, $500, $500, and what's the problem? Save. Okay, good, and done. Now let's see what happens. Let's change the January 3rd expense to $400 from the original $200. January 3rd expense, probably in Chase Bank. Reports, custom, trial balance, Chase Bank. So there's a January 3rd expense. This January 3rd expense was $200. Let's double click and let's change the amount to $400 and click save and close. It does not let you change it because it is before March 15th, the closing date. So let's go ahead and enter the password. And we click yes. Now it let us change it to $400. Now we will click reports, standard, and scroll down to the area of accountant reports, and you will see exceptions to closing date now lists only this transaction. It was originally recorded on December 9th. Then on December 14th, I changed the class, and that's why the class is in yellow. But today, December 27th, when I open it up, you see it's the money amount that was actually changed. And you may notice something else about this closing date exception report compared to the prior one a moment ago. What you may notice is that once you change or remove the closing date, the exception report will reset itself. That means that every time there is a change to the closing date, all prior data in the report will be removed. The report will start fresh with a new data after the change in the closing date was made. And you may notice we have only the recent change. The changes we made when the closing date was February 28th have been removed from this report.